So, good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I will like to welcome you all for joining the summer internship with IIT Bombay. Congratulate you for getting selected for this, because a number of students apply and there are a few lucky people who will get the chance to participate in. So, today I'm going to just give you a brief information about the type of projects we have declared under the group called CD. So, let's see what exactly is CDP. So CDP is the Center for Distance Engineering Education Program in the department in IIT Bombay, and basically it looks after the saving the knowledge base or technology available within IIT Bombay outside IIT Bombay. So how exactly different type of technological solutions can be developed and employed so that we can communicate with the distance people sitting at the corner of the country from IIT Bombay. These are a few portals that we are currently hosting for different kind of things. Just to give you a brief information, this is the Talk to a Teacher portal where exactly we have mentioned everything related with the talking the different students sitting across the country with the people sitting into the IIT Bombay. The other is the courses on view is more or less video portal available for educational video, like you may have seen MIT courseware or the Stanford for you or the connects or whatever. The similar kind of IIT Bombay courses are being available on courses on view. Whereas the Researchoscope is a specially developed portal for the research purpose. All PhD students put their work and related thing on this portal. You can visit this portal later. So I don't want to waste most of the time in explaining this. And the flagship project, which is very popular these days, is the Ask a Question. Ask a Question is the program in which any student or any individual sitting at any corner of the country can directly interact with IIT Bombay professor once in a week for solving his all queries. Currently, it is running into the two disciplines, electrical engineering, which naturally summarizing IIT system is electrical, electronic instrumentation, power and everything, and physics. So this is all about the small highlight of the portals available. These are different technologies which are being currently used to develop different type of solutions. But the actual type of technologies that we are going to declare for the summer internships and coming later. Now the opportunities which are available to work at IIT Bombay in CDIP group are like listed in the next slide. What you have to do at this time is that you find out the search, analyze, select the best option. What you like, you have to select yourself. We are just putting the things into for you and you can choose whatever you like. So these are the different scripting languages we are providing at this summer internship to be worked on. So these are the different, we have got a PHP color available, Python available, all Java, then embedded C, C++, then Android, Firefox OS for the mobile platforms, and then the OpenGL, OpenCV, Modelica, these are the some hybrid platforms which are available for working. Databases concerned, we have MySQL, SQLite, and Redis. Based on different type of applications, these are the small canvas of the databases through which you, we will ask you to select something which best fit with the type of application you are working on. These are the type of different specialized servers on which we are expecting people to work on in this summer internship, which includes the Asterisk. Asterisk is the basically software telephone exchange, which supports to the telephone call, video on demand call, kind of things. So it is a more or less a telephonic solution into a software. Then Red5, which is equivalent to the FlexEngine, then the Node.js and OpenFire. OpenFire will come later because this we have exclusively included this time because of we are launching a different project this year. Now engines. As far as engines are concerned, Unity 3D engines, which we are going to offer you this summer internship. Then the Phoenix is the search engine, whereas this Open Modelica is a modeling engine. So these are the three engines we are offering this year. Frameworks, yes, Spring, Hibernate, and YII. These are the frameworks that we are expecting that you should use this year. Now, how to break the barrier, how to go ahead, how to find out what exactly one has to do. So these are the project, these are the already listed onto the website. So these are the only four projects we have declared. First is the concept tutor. I will list out first and then we will go one by one in brief so that you will understand what exactly is. Then the open modelica-based simulator development. Then implementation of XMPP protocol for the cross-domain communication. And for those who are from the electronics background, hardware-related people, we are phonetic keyboard is the project we are launching. Now go. We will go step by step. Here is the concept tutor. Now, what exactly concept tutor is? Basically, I would like to tell you that this project is into its second year. Last year also, this internship same project was there, and a substantial work has been already been done by the last year summer internship batch. So the one level of development is already ready. You can have the ready reference available, and then you have to go ahead here carrying the same project ahead. Exactly what we are expecting in this project is that, you know very well nowadays the mobile gadgets are very popular. Even the kids are loving the mobile gadgets. They want tablets and gadgets. We are also promoting it. And what they do with this? They play games. They like games. So why mobile gadgets are being loved? Because of the games. We thought that why should not we use the gaming platform from the mobile or tablet based systems to teach them? So can we develop the gaming engines? So if we develop or mold a gaming engine into an educational game, people will enjoy playing the game. On the other hand, they will learn also. So by this module, this project has been launched last year, and a substantial amount of work has been done wherein the gaming engine has been used to develop the games. What we expect here is that the based on Android, we have only targeted right now with Android as the OS, whereas the Unity 3D is the gaming engine. So we are using Unity 3D as a gaming engine, add on which we are expecting that the people, if they can work on the OpenGL or DirectX or kind of thing, will be an added advantage. If you have got the knowledge of Android, Java, JavaScript, you can learn Unity 3D very easily because it is very simple gaming engine. The other thing is that what you should know, good interest into the games, you should have played some amount of games, and you should have good creativity. So this is the project basically aims in creating educational games. Okay, next. Next is the open modelica based simulator development. Now, you people may have come across lot of simulators. Especially electronics people use this PSPICE and other thing for simulation. AutoCAD is a good simulator. Or other people may be knowing that the MATLAB Simulink is a very popular simulator kind of thing, wherein you have to just drag down some boxes, connect them together and run the system and get the output. So it is very easy and fun for the people to check their concepts on the screen itself rather than or directly going to the field. So Open Modelica is the platform which provides you a basic tools available to develop your own simulation software. So what we are expecting this summer internship is that a student should develop a simulating software based on Open Modelica as a platform. It is open source, freely available platform. And based on this platform, we are expecting that student should develop a simulator. I don't know how many of you have gone through the typical subject modeling and simulation at this level. Maybe this is in the final year or pre-final year in different universities based on their own curricula. But this will give you the sense how exactly simulator has been developed, how exactly the work can be done. So it is a quite challenging and interesting work. Right now, we are also already working on this area. So we have around 3 to 4 MTech students parallelly working on the Open Modelica. So we have got one group which is working on Open Modelica. The Open Modelica itself is the open source software, and the Peter Fritzen, who is the prime developer of the Open Modelica, is also supporting and working with us. So the thing is that it is joint venture of original community with the IIT Bombay, and we are trying to find out some different reasons. So those who are interested in working on the simulation or modeling kind of project, this can be a good opportunity. Next is the implementation of XMPP protocol for the cross-domain communication. Now, just try to understand, This is a very common scenario. When you are onto the net, you are online into the Gmail. And then your friend comes online and you start chatting. Suddenly you change your tab and you go to the Facebook. And there is your other friend which is chatting with you. Right? Is it possible that the friend on Gmail and friend on Facebook and you together chat? This is what we are expecting here. But we are expecting this cross-domain communication. Right now it is only possible that Gmail clients can talk, or the Gmail login ID people can talk with the Gmail people, Facebook can talk with Facebook, and so on and so forth. So these cross-domain people can be bring together, and they can have a common platform wherein they can interact with each other, is the basic ideology behind this. This can be very well possible using the XMPP protocol. So what we are expecting, it is a little bit of a R&D kind of experiment wherein those who have got interest in working on your protocols and web technology and other things can take up this kind of challenge, where we are actually aiming to have the cross-domain communication. Initially, we are focusing, we should work onto the chat, and then it can be extended onto the video and audio also. So you can have the people sitting onto the Gmail and Facebook and can have the audio call or video call. Or otherwise, any other application also. Maybe it is Skype or maybe it is Yahoo or whatever. Okay? Next. Now, this is the last project that we are showcasing, is the phonetic keyboard. This is basically targeted to the students belonging to electronics background or the hard medium background. Now, you may have seen that these days, if you see the posts which are available on Twitter, Facebook or anywhere, 20 to 30% posts are in their regional language. You can find there in the things written into the Devanagari rather than the English or Roman, right? So maybe you are coming from different part of the country, you may have a Tamil statement or the Marathi statement or Gujarati statement in their own local script. So how exactly people do this? So this is a simple thing, go online. There is a Google Translate available, or there are the standard APIs available, there are so many sites available, wherein you just type in your spelling and press the space bar, it will be converted into your language. But for this, what is required? For this, it is required that you should have online, we should have the net connectivity, and you should have those particular access to the site where exactly this process can be done. So we are thinking, can we do all these things within keyboard itself? Oh, I have to go online. So can we develop a simple hardware which is being plugged into your computer? You just type in and it will convert into your local regional language. If it is quite possible, then this can be a bigger breakthrough, like a country like India, where we have a multilingual situation available, right? So this actually project focuses on this type of application or solution development, wherein this is called as phonemes, phonetic based keyboard, where the keyboard what we have available are called as the inscript keyboards. So from inscript to the phonetics, using certain small hardware, is the objective of this project, wherein we are expecting the people should have at least the knowledge of embedded C. All other rest of the things will be given by us. And for this project also, as far as the parallel corpus is concerned, or the transliteration is concerned, there is a group in IIT Bombay with Pushpa Bhattacharya, who is a CSE professor, who is already working on this line from years together, is going to cooperate. Already there are 2-3 MTech students have already done some kind of work which is in process. So if you join this, you can get a chance to work on this kind of solution. So, yeah.
What exactly will be displayed on the keyboard? You have to display some. I mean, in our keyboards, there is ABCD display.
ABCD.
You cannot display sounds on the keyboard.
ABCD. Because phonetic keyboards, everybody is using this type. Have you converted your own name into your own regional language script? How?
Okay, no, I have.
Whether you required any speaker to be?
Very
good. Similar. The same thing, the platform will remain same. What we are doing this time using a web API, in spite of using web API, we have to do it through the hardware solution. Right? Yeah.
Why can't there be a local JavaScript solution? Why hardware?
If we do the hardware, it will go straight away to the keyboard and people need not have to have the JavaScript install, configure, whether it is a Linux, Windows, Mac, whatever. Hardware is a rugged, robust, permanent solution. That is the only thing. So I want that the mentality of the people. Keyboard just plug-in works, should work.
Keyboard just plug-in software works.
Yeah, but there are so many software also. There are local softwares already available that we can download and use it. But hardware will be a rugged permanent solution kind of thing. So basically, this can be done in the ecosystem wherein there are few work already being done. There are few MTech students from IIT Bombay already have done some summer internship. People have already some work done. Some project every year we start a new project, we carry on the older project and kind of thing. So although it looks very complicated and thing, but it is a fun. It is a simple. So how it will work? So this. So the experiences and differences in the interest, what exactly we are going to do is that create discrete modules of every problem. How exactly we make it simple? We create a very independent discrete module of every problem. Establish a program parameters and the goals, what exactly you have to do and what is the goal you have to achieve in a small baby steps. And then assign a mentor or the buddy for every intern. So you will have a mentor, everybody will have a mentor who will closely associated with you, guide with you and work with you and conduct the performance review and feedback in the end. And there is a process that the continuous feedback every week also. So it is not the thing that the assignment has been given and end of the internship will ask the result. It is a continuous association with us wherein the mentor will be with you, he will support you and the revision will be done every week so that there should not be any backlog. If there is a problem, some kind of solutions can be given, a kind of thing. We have got a number of mentors available. I would like to introduce before I should go ahead. Wherein Harish available. Harish is actually Android and mobile platform coder. He is a Google coder also. So basically, specialization is on to the mobile platforms. We have got almost all the mobile platforms currently. We are working on Android, iOS. Then Windows, Firefox OS, and so on and so forth, whatever. Okay. Next is the Santosh. Santosh is a basically stronger person into the area of the Java. Java is the main domain. He is a Firefox open source community member, very active, conducted Firefox hackathon last year also in IIT Bombay and other things. So these people are more or less related with some open source community. So Santosh is going to help you on the all Java platform and platform and somebody else. Or next is the Amit. Amit is basically a network guy. He's basically interested in networks, protocols, and finding out the solution. He's good on Python also. So Amit is also going to support the XMPP, this protocol already he is working on. So next is the Pratik available. Pratik is the basically from the hardware background. So he was working with the industry for a long time into Bangalore and now he is came to later on. So hardware development, processor programming and analysis, he is a strong guy. So he is going to look after the electronics group, which somebody joins. Then we have got two ladies sitting behind. One is Madhulika. So Madhulika is again one of our mentor. She is an educational technologist and she basically looks after the technology related with the education, how exactly technology can be embedded with the education and other things. So the concept tutor is her brainchild that the gaming engines can be used for the education purpose. Another thing, this year also we are trying to rope in her to get some more exposure of utilization of the technology to the educational system, but we call in generally the educational technology. Next and last is the Selvarani. Selvarani is the, again, a database specialist. She work on all kind of databases and other things. Adam, she is a Wikipedian. She leads the women's editathon effort of Wikipedia in India. So these are also related to the Wikipedia community and other things. So in all in all, these people are going to help you in carrying out the internship that I have. So these projects will be jointly mentored by these people based on the type of assignment you are going to handle. we are not going to provide you the mentorship or the support or the things at this point of time, but we will assure you that we will provide a mechanism for staying connected with the, us after the internship. This is not the case that after internship is over, the last day we will say you goodbye and we will not recognize you. So if you go out and then you also want to get some help or some queries or questions or something to be done, we are there to help you out. Now, the working style, how exactly we are going to work. So there will be a project management tool there. Actually, the assignment will be uploaded. And then the assignment will have some timeline. Based on those timeline, you have to do the submissions. After the submission, the performance and monitoring will be done by your mentor. If it is okay, the next assignment will be uploaded. So this is a cyclic process which is going to turn around during the entire period of your summer internship. Now, what you have to do? You have to follow the rules of the institute. We have seen last year or previously also, some people have got their own habits of coming from different campuses. So when you are in IIT Bombay, you have to follow our rules. Then they follow the discipline, be punctual, respect all others. And the most important thing is work in team, because we believe into the teamwork. Individuals can't do anything. So the teamwork we are highlighting here desperately, because unless you didn't learn working into the teamwork, the result will not come. So thank you. Before I should go for the question answer session, I will just have some glimpses. These are the small photographs of last year's summer internship, wherein this is the Firefox hackathon happening, this is the Wikipedia hackathon happening for summer internship, this is summer internship farewell, and this. So working with us is a fun. People enjoy the work rather than, work is not the load, work is the enjoyment. So this is the 2013 summer internship photograph. I think I have got one small film also to show you, a 2 minute small film, and we will go to the question answer session.
Thank you.
thank you. If there are any questions, I can take. Yeah.
Sir, I have a question regarding how the projects are assigned. Like, we have 6 groups to select from. So, say, hypothetically, I have selected your group. Since I'm from a non-electronics background, I would be interested, say, in the XMPP protocol project rather than the phonetic keyword. So, you will segregate us based on our interest.
Yes, basically what happens, students get attracted by the names and the objectives of the project. So what happens once they get the choice, what we do internal assessment of the people, what kind of skill sets they have.
Anything like that.
And then based on that, you can swap the things.
No, we don't do anything like that. Okay, it's a process which normally, I would take about 8 hours to complete. This time I want to do it in 2. Okay. So what we have given you is 3 choices. Correct? Choice 1, choice 2, choice 3. Okay. I sort them on choice 1. Right. I have on the front, on the top, okay, a list which lists all the groups, what is their requirement, how much of the requirement is full. Okay, and how many people are there with first choice? Alright, I try to match first choice. Okay. Wherever, if nobody chooses a project, only 2 are there, then I will allocate. I have the totals also. So, okay, I have been told that I should write an algorithm for it, I have not done it. Okay, right. Now, basically, earlier, this time, that's why I said this time we are in a mess. Okay, last time we had asked people who are going to come for 8 weeks and 6 weeks. I had asked the projects whether you want 8 weeks or 6 weeks. Okay. So I had a color coding where 8 weeks people were green, other people were red. And a color coding in the projects. So I'll allocate the green people to green projects, that kind of thing. Okay. So it got nothing to do with anything you have done, it's the numbers that are there. Okay. So if all of you go in for first his project, second my project, third somebody's project, then it will be based on choice.
Okay. Once you
what I did last year, okay, is I that to be a no time. Okay. I asked the actually it was done I think on projects. I asked the project with the best chaos goal there, with the largest number of first choices. Okay. To come sit on my terminal and select which people they want. Since he was the most popular project, I gave him that choice. This time I'm not going to do that. Okay. Otherwise it would be the project which has got the, which is the least favored, will get allocated first. Okay. So if for example I want 30 and only 15 people choosing me, those 15 will get their first choice. Because if I allocate those 15 somewhere else, I'll have to go to second and third choice. Okay. So the algorithm is the least favorite projects will get allocated first. Okay. Because the most favorite project has got more chances that the second choice I can fill. Okay.
We have
to take
within group.
Correct. So within the group, is totally his discretion.
Within the group, you can laterally move.
Yeah.
Across the group is difficult.
Now obviously, he's not going to take electronics people and put them in the non-electronics project. No. There was a discussion long time back. Okay. Whether what we should do. Okay. So according to me, I said the students, let the students choose what are their strengths and this thing. Why do you think we are giving complex, not complex, etc. Okay. You earlier to all students were allowed to choose between 23 projects last for 1 year. Okay. So basically the person who is not that confident will choose a project which is less complex. Person who is good will choose a project. Let the student choose. Because he knows his strength instead of us going and interviewing so many people. Okay. So does that answer your question?
Yes, sir.
It's done in 2 hours. That's why I guarantee it will get done in 2 hours.
Anything else?
So the phonetic keyboard one, so you mentioned we need to know embedded C. Is that a necessity or could we learn it along with the process?
Which background you came from?
So electronics.
Electronics?
Yes. Not much of an idea.
So do you know C++ at least?
Yes.
Then it's fine. C++ and embedded C is more or less simpler, but you have to do extra work.
And sir, what about the hardware interfacing?
Hardware interfacing in terms of?
As in sir, the hardware part of it.
Hardware part, basically it is a microcontroller, this microcontroller. So that you have to decide which controller you want to. used and what.
So for the microcontroller part, we need to know the
No, it is the actual coding. Because see, the most of the thing what we are doing right now is the by software. Whenever you are using the online API also, it is a software-based solution. But we are going to put those software solutions into the hardware. So naturally, it is again a software written into the embedded C, hosted by the hardware. That's all.
So by embedded C, you mean Atmel coding? By embedded C, you mean Atmel coding?
Embedded C, you should know. Then you can choose the processor in the embedded C, whatever target or device you are going to like.
Embedded C should normally work on any processor.
Any processor.
There will be compiler for that processor. That is why you use C. Because C is the closest language to all processes.
Anything else? Okay then. Thank you. Have a nice time.
You should give him a clap. He is the best.